The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. John was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what he said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and you will see." So they went four in the was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which translated means Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. One of the primary ways that I like to spend time with the Gospels, especially when I'm preparing to be with all of you and to share my heart, share my love of the Gospels, is I really like to sit with the Gospels and I like to envision the experience of the Gospels that is taking place. I like to see it in my mind. I like to see it in my heart, especially. But I take it one step further and I always try and place myself within the gospel scene, just somewhere, so that I can truly try and see what was happening that day, so I can have a closer, more personal, more intimate experience with the gospels. So I ask you to just tolerate your deacon here for a moment, take just a quick journey with me, just for a few moments. I ask you here, those of you that are here, those who are joining us from home, just close your eyes for a moment. We just heard the gospel proclaimed. What does that look like to you? What does it sound like? What does it smell like? You know, we're just off the shore, right off the bank of the Jordan River right here. Maybe we hear the water from the Jordan slapping against the rocks up against the shore. Maybe we can smell the dates and the date trees that are so populated right here in this area. It's probably warm. Maybe a little bit dusty with the breeze as we stand on that dirt path. And in the distance, as we stand there with John the Baptist, we see a figure walking towards us. And as we get closer, we see that it's a man that's walking towards us. And as this man walks by, John the Baptist proclaims to all of us standing there with him, "Behold the Lamb of God." And in that moment, to all of us there, all of us right here, John was announcing, he was proclaiming the presence of Jesus in our midst. He was the presence of Jesus in each one of our lives. So as I did this throughout the week and I sat there and put myself into the gospel experience, I really wanted to challenge myself. Because I didn't want to just stand here before all of you and simply talk about, yes, it's important. We must look for the presence of the Lord in our lives. And yes, of course, we must. But I wanted to make it personal. So I challenged myself. I challenged myself that this past week, I wanted to truly try and experience and look for the presence of Jesus in each moment of my life of this week. And I'll tell you, sometimes it was very easy. Sometimes it was a little bit more difficult, but that's why it's a challenge. You know, every time I would turn on the TV, it would be COVID, 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 or, you know, the division that is happening amongst us and what's going on. And it would pull me out of it. But I would have to stop and take that moment and say, no, 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 challenge yourself. Look for Jesus in this moment that you're having. Look for the presence of Jesus. if something was stressing me out or something that was pulling me out of what I was looking to do, I needed to see Jesus standing right there with me. And it was interesting that I found out that when I truly took the time to keep my mind and my eyes and my heart open, I was kind of amazed at just how often I witnessed the presence of Jesus in my week and in my days and in the moments of my days. So maybe your deacon, as he gets older, is actually still learning some things, which is good. Maybe I'm going to get a little bit wiser and figure it out a little bit more. But I wanted to share with you just a handful of these moments that I had, because I feel like there are moments that all of us probably have in our lives to some degree or another. And earlier in the week, I had this wonderful opportunity. My beautiful, lovely wife, Wednesday, and I, we had this opportunity to actually go down and spend a few hours with my mom and my pops. And, you know, they've been keeping healthy, taking care of themselves. We have too. So we felt comfortable coming together at this time. And we got down there and I got to hug my mom, right? I got to hug my pops. We got to sit down and break bread together and have a meal and talk and laugh and smile and just be around one another. And one thing that I've learned from what's going on in our world right now is how important those moments are. I truly saw and experienced the Lord in those moments. In my mom's hug and her smile and my pops give me that bear hug that he always gives to me. Just sitting down with them, Jesus was present. And I'm not saying that I used to take that for granted, but I think it was so normal that I didn't truly grasp the absolute beauty of those moments. And I think we all are feeling that because, you know, 1 year ago today, we would have been in the church. At the sign of peace, I would have hugged Father. I probably would have hugged many of you in greeting as you showed up. I certainly would have been shaking hands with you at the end of Mass. But we're going to get there. It's coming back to us. But your deacon was reminded and learned this week, don't ever take that intimacy, that personal connection that we have with one another for granted. Look for and see Jesus in that moment. And then just another quick experience. One thing I like to do is I like to take a walk every day. I like to just go out, clear my mind. I like to walk and feel the sun on me a little bit. And, you know, nowadays I put my mask on, I put my earbuds on, I put on some Bob Marley, I go outside and I go take a nice walk. And earlier this week I was walking and I saw this lovely young lady, lovely young mother walking towards me. You know, she had her mask, I had my mask, so we felt comfortable walking towards one another at this time. And she was walking with her little child. I mean, just a little guy. Looked like he had just maybe mastered the art of walking because it was kind of still wobbly, but, you know, he was doing his thing. And as we got closer to one another, this beautiful little child of God started smiling, started laughing, left his mother's side, and literally ran towards me and embraced me, embraced my leg. And I stood there, and I kind of put my hands up because I wanted to make sure the mother was comfortable with what was happening. And I said, are you okay with this? Is this all right? And she said, he doesn't do this. This is wonderful. And in that moment, how could I not but behold the Lamb of God? How could I not experience the presence of Jesus and the love of neighbor that this little child of God was presenting to me? And then during the week, I had this gift kind of dropped into my lap. Towards the last minute, I was asked by Father Francis, who's the pastor over at St. Finbar, if I would fill in for him and teach a seeker session, which is a session they have every week where they break open a different topic. And I was like, of course, I'm available. I would love to do that. And it was such a gift because not only did I get to share what was on my heart with the topic, but I got to hear from sisters and brothers about what was on their heart. They got to share their love for Jesus. I got to share mine, they shared theirs, and it was a wonderful experience. And I truly felt the presence of Jesus in our midst. And then just yesterday, over at St. Finbar, I had the great opportunity and honor and privilege to baptize three beautiful, beautiful young ladies. And I was struck as I was outside, of course. We were outside in the grotto. We have a beautiful grotto over there with the Blessed Mother behind us. And it hit me that these parents were not going to let this moment in our history with this pandemic, they weren't going to let masks, they weren't going to let the fact that the three families, that these families had to social distance from one another, they were not going to let anything get in the way of their child's first sacrament, of their child's relationship, their child's moment of beholding the Lamb. So I was able to be inspired by these parents and their godparents, these godparents that were there and would not let anything get in the way of that moment. And then it got me to think even more. I thought a lot this week. It was a good week for my mind because I was thinking nonstop. But I was thinking, do we know Jesus when he stands before us? Now look, it's easy to stand here before Father and see Christ and what he does. It's easy to look out to each one of you and behold the Lamb, to see Jesus in each one of you, because we come here to do just that, to celebrate and work on our relationship with Jesus. But when we go outside the doors and we're face to face with one of our sisters or brothers that might be experiencing homelessness, do we see Jesus in them? Do we look for that image of God? Do we behold the Lamb in that sister or brother? When we see that grocery store worker that is working at this time so that we can get groceries, when we see our postal workers that are out there working so that we can get prescriptions and the notes and the cards and even the bills that we need, that to receive what it is they are doing for us out of love of neighbor. But also, and I think this is sometimes the more difficult part about it, and I'll be super honest with you, it's a difficult one for me at times, do we truly reflect that image of God? Do we reflect the presence of Christ inside of us to others? Because yes, we must behold the image of God. We must behold the presence of Christ, but we also must do our part to share that with everyone that we meet. And then I'll wrap up with this, because like I said, I was thinking and I was thinking of these experiences and the different ways that I can see Jesus in others, but it got me thinking about the experiences that each one of us has on a daily basis. Like I said, I got to go down to Dana Point. I got to go see my mom and dad. I'm an old surfer kid from Dana Point. So for me, when I see the ocean, when I hear the waves, maybe I'm fortunate to see some dolphins in between the sets, I see God and his creation. You know, I hit my mid-20s and went on my little gypsy lifestyle journey, got my first Harley Davidson, lived up in Sedona, Arizona for a couple of years, but I would ride out into the desert. I would sit on the mesa of a red rock and I would just be in awe of God's presence. So those are ways that I experience God through his creation. Each one of you, I'm sure, has various ways. You know, we see the sunrise, we see the sunset. I'm sure for many of you that have grandchildren, when you see your grandchild, of course, you behold the Lamb of God. You see Jesus's presence and your grandchildren, and our husbands, our wives, and one another. My point to it is we must be open. We must be aware of the fact that Jesus is presenting himself to us in every moment of our lives. And that's the challenge. The challenge for us is to not let the world, whatever is happening, get in the way of that. And when the world gets to be a little much at times, look for Jesus in that. Because he's present. He's present to each and every one of us. So my challenge that I took this week is going to be my challenge that I not only continue now, but hopefully I continue for the rest of my life as I still am learning. And I invite you to join me on this challenge. It's simply to maybe slow down a little bit. Be a little bit more quiet. Look for, listen for, watch for the presence of the Lord in our lives.
God, you don't need me, but somehow you want me. Oh, how you love me. Somehow that frees me to take my hands off of my life in the way.